So welcome to Bunny's Designs. This is a live show with live people having an atter in chat. It's recorded for Ustream.tv and also for YouTube for people to watch at their leisure. I'm continuing to work in Have a Serene and Magical Christmas, and I've chosen the little bird scene because some of these didn't really appeal to me. Now I know I do have a rule, but some of them really didn't appeal to me, and so I thought, well, that's fine, it's a thin book. I'll just do this. Is I can break rules for Christmas because I do like to start at the beginning of a book, because otherwise I forget pages. But there are some in here that I will not probably be using unless it's a practice. Any pages that you don't like, it's always a good idea to use them as a practice because it's the same paper. Excuse me, I have my Thursday cough, which I reserve especially for streaming live shows on a Thursday. So I'm working with my Derwent Graphitint pencils. There's a set of 24 colours and they're all kind of muted. They're not very bright and I kind of like that. I have Peerless watercolours, which are very vivid. I have the Hydrus, Dr. Martin's Hydrus professional watercolours, which are again very vivid. And then I have mediocre ones. I have pastels. I have Derwent watercolour pencils. I have Inktense blocks and Inktense. But these are to the other extreme. These are kind of really muted and love the colours. So I thought I'd finish this particular page off. And I am using them dry. I normally use them wet, but I am using them dry as an ordinary pencil. And I do like that about the Derwent products. I love my little sleeve, which they fit on the back. I have the full set of Inktense pencils and Derwent watercolour pencils, and the 72. And you can get 24 on a side. So you've obviously got three sides, and the fourth one, I have my Derwent Graphitint in. So I do like this particular Derwent sleeve that goes in the Derwent art bag. They're about £14-15 if you shop about, and you get three sleeves, and then you could buy, I think, about £6 or £7, you can buy three more sleeves or two more sleeves. And I quite like that. I've got six sleeves with double pencils at both sides, and I can still get erasers, pencil sharpeners. There's a nice pocket on it. There's a pocket at the front, and it has a shoulder strap and a strap. There is a video up there that shows all, in the playlist, it shows all the my Derwent art bag and what's in it. Excuse me. So you can get quite a number of pencils and pens in there. I have a double one for Caran d'Ashenir colour 2s. So you can get two of those in. And again, I like that. I love my near colour 2s, but I like to see what I've got. So I've got them in colour order, normally the same colour order, and it makes everything a little bit easier. I have my Derwent art bars in there as well. The pastel pencils, I have those in there. So they're kind of flexible. You can get quite a lot of things in here. You don't just have to have pencils. But I kind of like that for this particular way. And it makes them a bit easier, because if you don't have anywhere to do that, you can hang them up behind the door. I have three art bags and they hang up so that they're out of the way and I can just pick them up when I want. So I do love this way, and they are clipped in, but I prefer when I'm working to have them out because they're just handy to see every colour, get one out, put it back safe, and they're not falling about. Now my desk today is on a slope because I'm working on my draftsman's old-fashioned draftsman's table, which is a huge 5-foot table with a big fluorescent tube across, so that gives flat light. So this will be going in my new art studio, hopefully. So I'll zoom in and we'll finish off this page because it's not far away now. Now the Graphitint is like a pencil, like a 4B pencil 2B, but it has a colour in it. So, it's a dark pencil, it's rich. So you can't be too rough with it because you'll smudge it. Having said that, you can use the magic Derwent eraser, which shouldn't be too far away, and you can erase all that smudge, which I normally do last, so you can get the colour done. I think I did it on this one as well. This particular one here, this is Derwent watercolour pencils, but they are used as a pencil, and it will look better when it's finished. But what I've done is I've just gone over this section here, so I really have a snow highlight. Even though I've gone over with a little bit of grey, there are certain sections that I've made a highlight, so we do have a highlight of snow. So that's quite a handy thing to do, and you can do that with any kind of good quality pencil. Obviously, if you activate it, if it's a water base, you activate it, then you can't do that. I found that little eraser now, so I have that handy as well. But I normally do that at the end, and I've just taken it off the leaf just to give a bit of emphasis, and then I need to go underneath and think of shadows. So I've put a highlight on this one, but really it might be in shadow, so sometimes you want to replay. I'll just rearrange the light because that's your, on my camera. And I'll zoom in, and then we can see what's happening a bit better. And see if I can. And I haven't managed to do my fingernails today, so apologies. They look a bit. Should be fine. So I'm working with green grey number 9, meadow number 10, and ivy number 11. So I'm trying to put the palest one down first on the leaves. So just scratch a little bit of colour in the middle, and they're very kind of, they have a waxy tone. Now, a long time ago, I watched a video that Derwent released, and it was a gentleman called David Cook, and that's when I first fell in love with Derwent pencils, the watercolour pencils. And the beginning of the program is it showed you how the pencils were made, and at the end they were dipped. The strips were dipped. The strips of color were dipped into a wax, and that was, it said, to help it adhere to the page. And I found that if you look at these, they're a little bit waxier than the newer versions. And I'm wondering if they don't dip them anymore, because I haven't seen an up-to-date video. But Derwent is the oldest pencil company in the world, so they do know a little bit about making pencils, and you can kind of bring colours out and have some shadows and things. I think that could be snow. It's just not drawn as snow. And you don't need a lot of pressure on, so that's quite good because it means I can do that with hardly any pressure. Especially when I make the pencils line, the pencils quite sharp. I've had to give up using a blade, so I invested, I think about 7 or 8 pounds in the Coombe automatic long point pencil sharpener, and I really like this one, but I am collecting the dust and the well, it's not dust, it's the shavings, and I just need a little bit of a point on this one, so because I have quite a long, I mean, you can take it longer. I don't normally take it too far, but I get rid of the wood, but I keep the end, which is colour. And then when it goes into here, I never do it too long. And then when it goes to there, that's all watercolour. So I will be saving these and putting them in a nice big weld kind of watercolour palette, so that I've got lots and lots of puddles of colour. Probably in my little book, I've made a book for watercolours, so I could do that actually, of just of shavings. In fact, I think I might do that, so I better write a note, because I have a memory like a sieve. Pencil shaving colours in red book. I've made a little book. It's a photograph album, a mini one, and these little things here I'll be putting on squares of good quality sketchbook and wetting them to make a puddle and mixing them and then letting them dry. And remember that you might get a few bits because you're building up and building up, and this is supposed to be for watercolour, so I leave that one, and then what I'd do is just put a bit of a highlight on it, so it wouldn't be under here but here. Now I will go back and play because it won't be perfect, but it's just giving me an idea of, you know, that's going to give a bit more depth. And then I'll go back in and put some low lights in and then another highlight to finish. But I'm going to do that at the end. The main thing to do is to get a dead flat colour down, and then you can play with it. Then you can see, you know, that these are going at the top are going to be lighter than the ones at the bottom. I need to do this little section here. This has had two coats on it, and so again, I want to build. I want to get rid of that black line. So again, that's something to do at the end. Oops. So if you've got any questions, pop them in caps. Thanks for stopping by, guys. Hope everything's okay. I don't actually need a point. You see, if you needed a point, like I need to get to these sharp edges here, so I needed a bit of a point. But when I'm just colouring in round areas, I don't need a point. So there's not really much point in doing this. Pardon the pun. So the meadow one, I think, is the one I use first. I'll just move this across. I'm pretty sure this is snow. So if I leave it to last, and I can then work it out if it's snow or if it's another leaf or a cone. I thought it was a little pine cone, but I'm not sure now. And that pine cone needs to be darker, but I just wanted to fill it in so I knew it wasn't a leaf. So just give that a bit of colour. And then, again, I want to kind of... The only thing you've got to be careful is you can't press down when you have a point, because it will snap. But if it does snap, pop it in a little pot and add water to it, and you'll end up with a watercolour. And I must admit, I love watercolours with these tones. They're really unusual. They're like a grunge. So I do kind of like that. And then the third one, I think, was just a very gentle... scratch of colour over the top. So you get about three coats. This is about two, and then you can just see it waxing up a bit. So if we want any more lines in here, now's the time to put them in. Extra ones if they're not in. And then kind of little circular motions. And again, not very strong, because we don't want to oversaturate. You know, you really want two or three very light, thin layers rather than fat layers. And then again, you can think, well, there might be a highlight on that one, so make the leaf a bit more three-dimensional. Just on the tips there, perhaps. And then we'll move on to the next one. Just think about this line. Now I would like to get rid of this line, so I'm going to introduce probably a very dark brown, and then that will make it more of a dark olive, I think. And then going with the lightest colour first in the middle. And then that should have a mixture of both. And of course it's going to be dark here because that's behind that other leaf. And I think you can start to play. And again, a bit like the pastels, you don't have too many layers. Not with these pencils. They get to a stage where you're making bits, and then you realise, well, that's as far as we're going to get. So again, going with the eraser, and it's getting quite dirty as the eraser, but I'm not bothered. Again, I just want to emphasise just a bit of form, so we know that that leaf isn't flat. It's got a bit of depth to it. And I will be going back into there because there's too much there. So I'm going to go, I'll do the berries next. So the berries, I think I've used, there's a port and the other red is burnt, is autumn brown. And they're both quite nice reds. And again, you need sometimes a little bit of paper. So there's only two real reds, and one's a browny russet red. Number 17, autumn brown, and the other one is port. And port is just that bit pinkier, that bit warmer. So if you want a cold red, you want to use the autumn brown, but if you want a kind of a berry colour, that's what you'd use. Now just a tiny bit, just a little bit, and then the light's coming across and underneath you can then kind of just give that a little bit of an emphasis, and that's kind of really, really darker now. Again, the highlight's in the wrong place, I think, but and then if you go over your highlight, your really white highlight, you haven't to worry too much. And again, I want a bit down there, a bit down there. And I did go in with a darker colour over the top, but I'll do that last. And then you can play with the really lights and darks and the cherries. And again, you're making those appear round. So I've lost the highlight on that one. So it's not very clean, so it may not work. You can just touch. And if it was underneath, you might not want a shiny highlight. You want a dull highlight. So you get your shiny highlight and then you'll go back over it very gently and make it darker, but just for this moment we can leave those as they are, and then we'll just get them all. So you can see that's a lighter one, you can leave it lighter, or you can just build up a little bit. Now you would probably want a point on this because it's just nicer, but it's making those cherries round instead of flat. Sorry, not cherries, they're berries. Beg your pardon. I'm getting like Hilda Baker. I'm mixing my words up. So these will be leaves, but though I don't want them the same as olive. So I've got the three greens I've been using for the, so the holly berries. This one is slate green, and then what I normally do is use my little book of watercolours, but I've put it somewhere. So we'll just have a quick, oh yes, it's a different green, so that's worked quite well. So we can just put a very light, and again it's like a grey green, this particular one. So the grey green is cold, and of course it's like a blue spruce, because a blue spruce is a blue green. So actually that's worked quite well. It's a very, very, very subtle green, is that? But we can go back in there and play. What I want to do is just get all this with some colour on it. And it's kind of, it's like when you're doing traditional art, you do your preliminary sketch. I've never done a thumbnail, but I think I may start to do a thumbnail for composition, and I may start to do that. And then you want your colours in there as well, and play with colours and decide what colours you want. And then you go in there and you give everything a kind of mediocre middle tone. So everything gets one flat, soft tone, unless it's watercolour and you have to work light to dark. And then what you can do is go darker and darker. And so your first one is your palest. Now, if you're working in oils and acrylics, you don't need to do that. You put a mid-tone on and then you go highlight and low light and low light and highlight until you get what you want. So we've managed to just give that a little bit of a... And of course, now you can see that that one's going to be darker. But I am going to do a point for that because I really want this snow to stand out. So I've got this one next. And again, there is a little bit of dark brown on that because I've gone over. So we just need to take this razor. And the other thing is, the beauty of this is you can take this, it'll be slightly stained, but you can take it right back. Now, I do need to go behind there with the brown for the shadows, but again, that's another thing I want to do, is to come back and put the shadows in here. And again, the low lights and the shadows. But just for this minute, just want to get, and if that is snow, then I would like to get rid of that black line, and it makes that just a bit more realistic. And it's just a very, very soft coat, so I don't have to worry. And we've got dark, a dark indigo at the back, so again, that's another thing that's finished. Just one more here. Oops, and behind there, you see, I've forgotten that. And because I know that that's going to be a lot in shadow, I'm not really going to be bothered that a little bit of that soft green gets on into that colour. Because the wood is going to be very dark under there. And that'll show up these. Two on the roof, and again, because everything else has been done and it's dark, I can just gently go over that just giving that a hint of this green, which is a different green to the other one. Now you can make your own greens if you want, or you can change the greens. You can add a paler green to this if you want. I actually quite like that. I like the tone of it. It makes that a warm leaf and that a cold leaf, which a blue spruce or a pine is normally cold. So we've popped that there, so I'm going to put that one back because I don't need it yet. It's number 8, slate green. So that is looking like it's more and more snowy to me. I'll very quickly do the berries. Just with a little bit of a soft. And I shall go get the highlight a bit later and after. I mean, it's better not to. If you want the whitest of white, then you can't go over it. Or put a tiny little blob, a tiny dot, with a colour shaper of masking fluid. And that will protect your white whites. And you can do that for most things. Wouldn't bother with oils and acrylics, especially if you're doing impasto, but it would work quite well. But seeing as these are low down anyway, I think the highlight up here wants to be brighter. So we'll just put this, spare me 2 seconds. My husband's got an emission. My husband's got an emission to pick up some Star Trek memorabilia for my daughters. Right, off we go. So we want the palest first, which I'm using Meadow number 10. So of course, if this was watercolour, you'd do the whole leaf in the palest of colours, and then you'd let that dry, and then you'd go over it again with the next palest colour and leave the highlights alone. And then you go to the next and you can paint over that colour and leave the next one. And you do that so many times until you're going to put your shadows in. Okay. I think I'd like to try and get rid of this black line, but I almost did that up there, so we'll have a play. And I managed to do that in the little cottage with the Derwent watercolours, and there's one called Chocolate, and any pencil that's called Chocolate has got to be darn good. So I used that instead of black for some warmish shadows. And again, you've just got to be a bit careful that you don't snap that nice long nib. But if you do, sorry, point, it's not the end of the world. And now we just want to give all that a little bit. Now you're going to lose some colour, but it is under there. And then there's another leaf under there, which is even darker behind the first one. That wants to be, I think that wants to be brown, that under there, so I'll leave that. And then I'm just going to just very carefully put a little bit of a... And I can only do this because I've already done the dark. If you hadn't done the background, you'd want to just be very careful. But because I've already done the background, it's not going to do any damage. And that's just taken that off. Oh, bye, Jane. Have a good day. Thank you. Enjoy your day. And I could make that a bit darker, but just for the first layer, again, just emphasise the fact that this particular leaf has got ridges. It's a curly leaf, it's not flat. Some leaves are flat, this particular one isn't. And you might want to get a better highlight. And then I'm going to go with this darker one under here, over the top, just gently. Because this leaf is obviously going to be a lot darker than the others. I'm still keeping that little bit of a highlight. Just a very soft. And you can either do little circular motions. Now I don't have a point on here, so I can get away with this because it's all rounded. If you had a point, you'd end up with a line. You've got to be a little bit careful, but as I said, there's no point me having a point on there because it needs to go anyway. So I've got a bit smaller one here, but it still wants the lines to break it up and give it a bit of contrast. You could possibly argue that you'd want a finer point and get some really fine detail on that. I'm trying to turn the pencil round a little bit every time. I'm just going to colour that one in like this. You can colour it in like this and use the eraser as your highlighter if you want, and charcoal you can work that way. And then we can kind of put a little bit of the green in there. And then dot a little bit. I think it's because this is actually quite dirty now, so my highlights aren't showing up as much. But you can get all sorts of so I'll go that way, and then we're going to put, see if we can find a way to get rid of this. Now my point has gone blunt again now, so but I'm not using this as the darkest. This is kind of, it's darker and then it gets a bit kind of lighter, but it's still fairly dark because this is a crease, almost like a crease. So we'll play with this in a second and then get some more darks. Sometimes we'll do them all while I'm here and do the next one. I mean, there's nothing to stop you going over it with a pen. I might do that in a bit to really bring those darks. Is use my little rotary pen, my technical drawing pen, but this is to just do this last one. So you can still see the line through. I'm not really bothered about this line because of course that gives it a bit of interest. It's the black line on the outline. I don't know why. I would have preferred that to be pale. Sorry, thin, as thin as these veins, and then it would have, you would have been able to get rid of them, but we may still be able to get rid of them. Oh, I'm running out of pain, so a little bit of green in here. Change the green, you can do. Again, little circular motions is not going to make lines because we're not adding water to this. I mean, you can add water to it if you want, but because we're not adding water, we want everything soft. We don't want any lines unless that's what you're going for, you know. That's why I pick a page that you don't particularly like. If you like them all, photocopy it, and then if you can colour it in photocopy paper, it's normally a bit thinner, so eventually you'll get quite proficient at colouring. And again, you can, if you want, just do the shadow and let the leaf have its space. You can build up colour. Just very gently getting a list. Oops. And then we can see how well that white snow pops out at the top. And so this is very rough. You can go back in with extra colour. Add highlights and then take them back with a very soft pencil glaze. And then if you want the really highlight, you want to clean erase the end and really give it a nice effect. Pop those back. Just go back into the berries just to give them kind of a bit of oomph. So we know that these are round, they're not flat. And this is having reflective light, so that would be dark. And you just make them a bit rounder. So two coats on the top, apart from the highlight, and then a third bit on the bottom. So we've made all our little berries a little bit rounder. So you can either do each individual one straight away, or you can just put a bit of colour and emphasise where you want the shadows to go. To make them that little bit realistic. Oh, hi King! Hi Kangaroo Babe, welcome to Bunny's Designs. Sorry, squinting at the screen. Welcome to popping in, anybody else having a look. I'll pan out and you can see roughly what we look like now. Oopsie. So the snow really does pop out now. And even though you haven't got much detail on there, it seems to be a bit better. And I've missed this light green, at least a little bit under there. And again, you can go as you can start going dark now, so under here will be dark. And then it'll show up the ones at the front. And the same with this one. So we could sharpen this one a bit. I'm just going to play with, might just do this bit here. So again, I'm going to have to sharpen my pencil. Using my new pencil sharpener. Now, I don't normally go to the end. I will do, as I say, when I get a bit more sorted with collecting the pigment, but I don't want to waste it because I'm a tight Yorkshire lass. So I'm going to just, and again, there isn't much pressure, but you can really get a nice dark effect. But you'll probably find just a very soft second layer. And and then you can't tell the difference. So we have Midnight Black, and again, I do want a sharp point. I do have that, but I do need a point, so I need to get rid of on a slant at the moment. So in here is all gorgeous colour. So I need to keep this. It's actually quite a nice green, so I'm going to be putting black in there. So and when you see this, this is all that on here. Is pigment, so I knock it off so that it goes in there. So that's what happens if you take it right to it, and then you I've broken it because it was too rough. And it won't sharpen it until I move that out, which is pest, really. But that's pure black colour. So it's going in there, and it will be mixed with something or other. So I hate to do this. And then really carefully twist it into the number one, and it makes it go to a point. And I only need to do that with this one because I do want to get in here. Now if I put a layer of black over the top of that green, it isn't a black, it's a green black. And then you can start to kind of emphasize certain areas to pop out or recede. And the other thing you can do is you can get rid of the black line. And you've made that red very dark because it would be in there. And if we put perhaps more dark here, the cherries will pop out. And we can get rid of that black line. So you can either do it with the cherry or you can do it with the leaf, depending on which is going to be the darkest. Making that cherry pop out. So it's made that little cherry pop out. Now I am going to lose that shadow because I want to lose the black line if I can, and then you soften it. But we still got the red underneath. And then we've got this highlight on top here. And some of them will be more shadows than others. But I actually think the highlights are in the wrong place. So you can play about with them if you want. The same with this body here. I'll just move up a bit. And I want to get rid of, if you want to get rid of this black line, you've got two choices. We want that nice highlight, so I suggest we darken this, because it's going to be in shadow anyway, and then just soften it kind of a little bit. So we've made a shadow and we've almost got rid of that black line. Now, it's difficult where the legs are, but not impossible. Because again, we can take the line behind the robin's legs and in front of it. So we've not touched the robin's leg, we've done the background, but it's made the leg pop. And then we just put a little bit of a shadow over it. So we know that that's in shadow. So we've still got our light, which we can go over the slate green and create. More greens. And the same with the snow. We can take that out. So you do this last and you don't press on hard because you break your. And you've taken away the line and yet you've not done too much damage because it's a background now. So see if we can do this leaf and make this leaf kind of so we want the tiniest bit and then blend it out. So it's making that leaf pop out and it's making the other one recede. So instantly you know that that's in front of this one. And then we take our green and take it back to the black so it becomes a green black. And then we can just lighten it up a bit. And then do the same down here. I mean, this is a dark painting, this is a dark colouring perhaps. So it's going to be quite dark. And again, we can do that with the pine cone. We can make that blend away a bit. So, and I started to use black a bit more as well. So again, and this is why you need a point on your black, because you do really want to get a nice effect. So we can get rid of this line and then take that black to green. And you only need to touch it where the others touch it. At the top here, we can go back to our paler green, because these will be sticking out more and they will be getting light. But again, underneath it will be dark. I haven't gone into this section. So that little bit there, we've got rid of this black line. Now you're getting to the point where there's bits, so you know you're not going to get anything else now, because you've got five or six layers now. That's it, that page is full. And the black works quite nice with that particular, one. Oopsie. Oh, thank you, V, thank you. So we'll go down with the black and then blend it out to the green. So now we've got black over green, we've got the pale green, and then we've got second layer. So what we can do now is just a nice even coat now. Oh, dropped it on the floor, that's not a good idea. But then we can go back under here. So remember what I said about highlights? The highlights look lighter when they have a darker shadow behind them. So we've got a highlight next to a dark, and a dark looks darker because it's next to a highlight. And if we really want to emphasize this, we can turn this eraser around. I still keep this. I turn it around. It's given me a clean, sharp, crisp edge. And this is where, this is where you get. So you've gone from black to white. And if you wanted to take the tops off, you're really going to get a nice highlight because you've got the black behind. Now that black shouldn't really be black because there should be another brown on there. So I think I'm going to do, I think cocoa. On that little bit there. But again, take the black to that leaf. So I've gone from black, black, and then we can just do the middle blended brown. So we'll have a highlight in the middle and we'll have a very dark shadow. And it will make these two pop out. Same at this side. A bit of black. We want black here because we want rid of these lines. And then we need to blend it with the brown. So light in the middle. And then really try to blend that black out. And then if you really wanted a highlight, I won't do it with this one, but you would just knock a bit of a highlight onto there. But underneath is going to be darker. So we can almost take that to black to get rid of that line. Because we certainly don't want that line. And we're getting to the point where we're saturated with colour. Emphasize that black, and then that's brought these leaves, pop them out a bit further. So I've only worked in this little area here, and I've dropped my pencil, which I shouldn't have done. So again, black there coming out, and I've used indigo, I've used dark indigo for the background, and that's made the blue black now. But of course it's going to be really dark down there. I mean, this is dark anyway, but now it's all dark, so if I pan out of it, you might be able to see. Oh, thank you. Let me just see if I can find what's happening. So you can see that is kind of looking a lot better down here, because I've tried to get rid of, and here's quite nice because we've got rid of that black line, but we've got a shadow. So now the little bit of light on the breast of the robin is kind of looking a lot brighter than this one, because this one has a shadow, a low light next to it. So in order to make a highlight lighter, you add a shadow next to it, and if you put a shadow, a light highlight next to a shadow, your shadow looks darker. So it looks a lot better just by going that bit darker. But I love the colours, really unusual colours. There's only one quick scribble of colour on there. But I do like the fact that here now is looking a little bit kind of more realistic. We've got rid of some of the black lines, and we've really made those berries pop forward, which this bit pops forward, that's going to stick out. You can tell it's sticking out. You can tell this bit's sticking out, and you can tell that there is a little bit of back of the little birdhouse, because it's very dark, but there's a little bit of light bobbing in there. So that's the end of the second part of the Serena Magical Christmas with the Derwent pencils, the graphy tint. Thank you for watching.